If you're not happy with your job or just want to make more money, I've got 5 income sources you can use to make thousands a month. In fact, I've made over $350,000 from these 5 sources alone and just closed January at over $20,000. I'll show you how to get started, how much you can make, and how to ditch the rat race forever. We're talking online income streams today on Let's Talk Money.
Beat debt.
Make money.
Make your money work for you.
Creating the financial future you deserve.
Let's Talk Money.
Hey Bowtie Nation, Joseph Hogue with the Let's Talk Money channel here on YouTube. I want to send a special shout out to everyone in the nation. Thank you for spending a part of your day to be here. If you're not part of that community yet, just click that little red subscribe button. It's free and you'll never miss an episode. Now, Nation, let me tell you a story and see if it sounds familiar. I hated my first jobs after college. I worked in corporate finance because I thought that's what the career path I wanted. The work gave me no freedom to make my own decisions. I had no control over my income, and it felt like nothing I did really mattered. So I latched onto the idea of early retirement. I saved every penny, took side jobs, all for that idea of that financial independence early retirement. I mean, I was FIRE before FIRE was a thing. And this is the whole reason that whole FIRE movement is pure bullshit. Nobody really knows what it is or what it really means. You know, at best you become rich, retire early, and become some sunburnt alcoholic. At worst, you're chasing a dream that keeps you chained to the old way of work, a slave to the 9-to-5 grind. Thinking about this, I realized I needed to create something else. I not only needed to create that income I could live on, but something that would give me a purpose and make retirement pointless. 6 years later, and I've made over $360,000 from my online income sources and cleared $20,000 in the last month alone. I grew my monthly income by over 70% last year. Much more than the money though, the 5 income streams that I'm going to show you today have given me that sense of control over my financial future. They've given me a purpose that gets my ass out of bed in the morning, and I can't imagine not doing this every day. So I'm going to open up the books, show you directly from my income spreadsheet the sources I use to make money, how much you can make, and how to get started fast. First though, as an informal poll of the nation though, what would you do if you had $10,000 or $20,000 a month coming in from these sources? What does financial freedom look like to you? What would it allow you to do? So scroll down and tell us in the comments below, what would that look like for you and what could you do with that money? So here again is my income tracking for all my online business. That's the blogs, YouTube, everything except freelancing, which I haven't done in a couple of years anyway. And if you scroll all the way back to 2015, you can see the first income source I started was self-publishing. And self-publishing is easier than people give it credit for. You know, everyone has a book idea in them. What's that book you wanted to write? The one where you were an orphan that finds out he's a wizard and has to fight an evil sorcerer that killed your parents? I bet that would be a good one. So if we go to the separate tab where I track my book revenue, I've made just under $85,000 on 12 books. And that doesn't include the $15,000 from selling the rights to one of these last December. So actually right around $100,000. Scroll down to the graphic and it's been pretty consistent. I published quite a few books quickly but then took about 30 months off to work on other income streams. Otherwise, this number would be much higher by now. Now understand, when I say self-publishing, I mean writing out a book and uploading it to Amazon to sell as an ebook on Kindle. You'll also sell it as a paperback and should record an audio version to really max out that income. Now we've got a playlist on the channel for self-publishing and I just published a book detailing my entire process for developing your idea to making writing easy. I don't want to spend too much time here since we've already got those videos on self-publishing. I want to spend more time on these other income sources that we haven't talked about yet, but I do have 3 tips to get you started and making money with your own books. First is, don't feel like you have to be the world's expert in a subject just to write a book about it. You see, people don't buy books for the information. They buy books for the transformation, and there's no better way to help them achieve that transformation than sharing your own personal story of growth. Your experience has value, and that's what you put in your book. So research the topic, everything for someone would need to make that transformation, to achieve that goal, but don't overlook your own stories and your personality as a piece of that. Next is to build this into your content strategy. What I mean by that, and this is something we'll talk about next, is that you probably have a blog or a YouTube channel, something to help promote these income sources. So you're already having to create that content regularly, writing posts or doing videos for the channel. Make this all easier by combining the two. Plan out your book from first to last chapter and write 1 a week for your blog. Now I see so many would-be self-publishers that sit down to write an entire book and just get stuck watching that cursor blink on their computer. Don't try to write a book. Write 1 chapter at a time. Use that content on your blog or your YouTube channel. Then when it's all finished, put it together, refine it a little, and you've got a book finished. Not only is this an easy way to write and keep up from that writer's block, but those blog posts are going to be an instant marketing source once your book is launched. Finally, here is that it's all about your book launch, that first week or two when your book is available on Amazon. If you can rank your book on Amazon and with some of those initial sales, it takes very little after that to keep a book ranked and making sales on the world's largest e-commerce site. Now, to get those first sales, it's going to be a little bit more directness than most people are used to. So this is going to be a growing experience for a lot of people. But you need to start talking to people a month in advance and then directly ask them to buy a copy during that launch week. This isn't something you can just drop a post on your Facebook feed and figure people are going to click through. You have to ask them directly in a personal message because that's the only way to really get the results you need. Now, next, I started making money with affiliate marketing, first a few hundred dollars and then growing steadily to over $6,000 last month. Now, we should probably back up a little bit here and talk about that idea of blogging or having a YouTube channel and making money with that. So when most people say that they make money blogging, what they actually mean is from all these sources that we'll talk about, from self-publishing, affiliates, sponsorships, and their own products. A blog itself is just a bunch of pages and words on the internet. It doesn't really make money by itself, but it brings people and that's your distribution. Think of it like your local Quickie Mart. Those bags of Cheetos and bottles of Yoo-hoo, that's the stuff that's actually making the money. The Quickie Mart is just how you get those Cheetos to the customer. In the same way, these income sources are how you make money, but you need that blog or your YouTube channel to get them in front of your customers. Now, I want to keep this video focused on those income sources, but I've got a free checklist on how to start a blog, and I'll link to that in the video description below. It's going to give you everything you need from getting online to growing your blog and make it super easy, so make sure you check that out. But I want to get back to affiliates because this can be a huge revenue source, and it's really easy to set up. Now, affiliate marketing is just talking about a product or a service, then putting a link so that people can click on it to learn more. If they go to the website and end up buying a product or a service, you get a commission from that. Now, there are a couple of warnings here, though, with affiliate marketing. First is you don't want to be selling out to just any affiliate product. This is your community, your blog readers, and you don't want to alienate them by being a shill for just any shitty products. So you only partner with affiliates or products that you'd use or recommend to your mother. Another warning for affiliate marketing is you're not going to make money talking about just any product. You've got a niche here for your blog, so you generally talk about a certain topic. Now that means you're going to be attracting people interested in that topic and you can market products around it. For example, talking about that new Black & Decker toaster, no matter how great it is on your pet grooming blog, probably isn't going to get too many sales. Find the half dozen or so products that really solve a problem for your audience and stick with those. Now, if we jump back into my income report, it kind of looks like I'm breaking my own rule here with 68 affiliates that I've worked with, but understand, this is over 6 years, 6 blogs that I've owned, and a YouTube channel, so there's a lot of different topics that I've covered. So I've made just over $147,000 on affiliate commissions, and last month was over $6,000 alone. But if we look at these top performers, really only a handful produce the biggest share of the income. Just 4 of these account for 60% of the total income, and you can see in January that just 4 affiliates were 80% of the income, so definitely that less is more rule. We've got Bluehost here, which is the web hosting that I use for my blogs and recommend to new bloggers. We've also got M1 Finance and Webull, the two investing sites that I'm using lately. We're using M1 Finance for our 2020 dividend portfolio, and I love the features on Webull for research and stock trading. The other big affiliate here has been Fundrise, the real estate investing site that I started using last year, and I'm really happy with it. I invested $1,000 last October and have already made $20 in dividends and $24 in appreciation, so that's a 4.4% gain in just 4 months. So you can make a lot of money with affiliates, and I want to show you how to set this up and a few tips to be successful. Now, the easiest way to get started making money here is just to join what's called an affiliate network. Now, these are sites like CJ Affiliates, ShareASales, others like Rakuten that connect affiliates with publishers that like you. So you go to these affiliate networks, you search for the products and companies relevant to your topic and the ones you can use. Then if they have a program, you'll get a special link that's going to track when someone clicks on that and give you credit for a commission if they buy something. Now, of course, you can't just start spamming these little links all over the internet. It's annoying and people aren't going to buy something just because you said to. You have to actually demonstrate the product, compare it to some of its alternatives, or basically provide some kind of information that answers a question for people. You provide that information about the product, your experience using it, and then let people make their own decisions, whether it's a good deal for them. That's how you serve your community at the same time as making money with these affiliates. You answer the questions and let people make their own decision. Now onto a couple of tips for making as much money as possible with these affiliate marketings. First is, like we talked about earlier, find those few products that really solve a problem for your community. Focus on answering every single question around those four or six products. You also want to do this in a few different types of posts. So we talked about those comparison posts where you compare the alternatives. For example, if Coca-Cola was an affiliate, then you'd make a post comparing that Coke and Pepsi and as many of these other alternatives, like maybe Dr. Pepper or juice drinks, really give people as much detail as possible. You can also do detailed step-by-step reviews of a product. Tell people exactly how to use it for that maximum effect and then share your experience using it. Finally, you can even do a video review for it. The next income source I started making money from was sponsored posts and sponsorships. Now, there are some slight differences here between these two income sources, so I could probably list them separately. So sponsored posts are when someone pays you to put an article on your blog, usually with a link back to their website. It helps get the word out for their product and adds a little SEO value for their search traffic. You'll get lots of offers from $30 to $50 for these, but even a small blog should be charging $100 minimum for a post, and I've seen these as high as $1,000 each. The real money, though, is in these traditional sponsorship ideas, so a company is going to pay you to represent it and try out its products. Now, I've just started on these over the last couple of years, but it's already more than half of that total $45,000 I've made from these two income sources. Sponsored posts will pretty much come to you, but you'll have to work a little bit harder to get those sponsors. Look around similar blogs and YouTube channels to see what other bloggers are promoting. Another good resource is the sponsor list for conferences in your topic. So which companies are paying for booth space or sponsoring those events? Reach out to these sponsors by email and make your pitch. You might start off by asking for just a demo copy of their product to test out and ask what's worked in the past for their advertising. For how much to charge sponsors, look at how much traffic you usually get for your videos and blog posts. Then estimate how many of those visitors click through for your affiliates or your links and apply that number to the rates you find on Google AdWords for keywords related to the product. That's how much the company would expect to pay for that kind of traffic, and you can generally start negotiating around that amount. You don't need to be a professional athlete or some makeup diva to get sponsors, and it's an income source that can really make a lot of money. So I know that I said a blog or your YouTube channel is your distribution and really doesn't make money itself, but there's an exception here, and you see it in this line for YouTube ads. I made just over $1,200 in the first month that YouTube was showing ads on the videos, and have seen that grow to over $8,000 in January. So YouTube can be that product all by itself because the platform is going to show commercials and those ads on your videos. I also make money through these other sources though, so talking about affiliates and getting sponsorships, I make money through YouTube with those as well, but the ads have been surprisingly a big source of income. Now, starting and growing a YouTube channel is a whole series of videos in itself, so I want to link to one that's going to get you started in the description below. There's just so much here to talk about, from getting started and making videos to growing a channel. What I can tell you though is that anyone can be successful on YouTube. I mean, look at me. We're talking a face perfect for radio, and my voice is somewhere between Gilbert Gottfried and a whiny five-year-old. Anyway, check out that video linked in the description on starting a YouTube channel, because this is an amazing resource, not just for making money, but also connecting with a lot of people and just having fun with it. Our next income source is kind of a catch-all. So if you scroll through here and you see that I started my first course in December 2018, and since then have added another course and a few other products. So this is not just video courses, but products like spreadsheets that I sell through the blogs. I'm still developing these, but I feel like this could be really the next level for the business. For example, this investing spreadsheet that I'm developing right now, this thing is going to have some great features on it that you won't find anywhere else. You'll be able to analyze your portfolio, compare a stock against sector averages or another stock, just lots of unique information all done automatically in the spreadsheet. Now, being able to create a product like a course or even a traditional physical product, it just works on so many levels. You won't have to settle for just a commission like with you, what you do on affiliate marketing. It's also something that you can keep on selling, unlike sponsorships, which you have to try to renew every year. Products are where your business needs to evolve if you're going to start making the real money. Now, one way to get started here is just think about your self-published books. So maybe converting those into a video course or some kind of other product idea. You can also think about, what are those most frequent questions you get from your readers? How can you answer those questions or those needs with a product? Now, even though you can make a lot of money with any of these income sources, you'll notice that I've used all of them together to really grow the business over these 6 years. The cash flow from any of these can be volatile from month to month, but together, they really give you a chance to build something amazing. Now, all of these ideas take some time to set up, but I've created another video on my favorite 7 income sources for making fast money. Click on the video to the right for all 7 ideas to make $10,000. Don't forget to join the Let's Talk Money community by tapping that subscribe button and clicking the bell notification.